The Collings Foundation's Wings of Freedom Tour brought rare World War II bomber and fighter aircrafts to the Tampa Executive Airport for display.
The Collings Foundation is based out of Stowe, Massachusetts. It's a foundation that's set up to share the living history of the aircraft of World War II, some of which are represented here today. So we travel the perimeter of the United States and throughout the heartland of the United States, sharing this with others.
The B-17 Flying Fortress, B-24 Liberator, and P-51 Mustang fly to pay tribute to the veterans and families that share the freedom they helped preserve.
I'm flying a North American P-51 Mustang. Obviously, this was a fighter escort that escorted the bombers to the target, so it could outmaneuver the opponent, and so we could help protect our bombers as they were going in to drop their bombs over the targets and escort them back, because obviously the bombers had very little capability. They had guns on board, but they were not as maneuverable and agile to fend off the opponent.
Tens of millions of people have come from all over to witness this interactive traveling display.
So we get the World War II veterans, very exciting. It gives me chill bumps just thinking about it. We have them. So they're telling their stories. Grandfather was a veteran that flew in a B-24, flew in a B-17, flew a Mustang. So we're getting to connect with those people.
And you can see names of those war heroes all across the B-24 Liberator.
People come that have donated money, and they look for their name of their grandfather, what squadron or outfit he was in during the war. So that's what they're honoring.
We had the opportunity to chat with George Washburn, a 95-year-old veteran who was a pilot in the war.
I flew one of these things in combat over Europe, flying out of England, and I did 19 missions as a co-pilot, and then I got my own crew at the age of 20, and I was a little guy, I only weighed 145 pounds, and so I did 16 more missions as first pilot on one of these with a 9-man crew at 20 years old. So, I was one of the younger 400 pilots, I think. Most of them were a year or two older than that. But we had electric heated suits because it would be 60 below zero at altitude, because we could go up to 5,000 feet in these. And oxygen, of course, breathing oxygen.
So what is it like coming out here today and seeing these?
Oh, it's great, because I got my daughter from New Hampshire. She's known what I did, but she's never been near one of these things. And they were gracious enough to let me up in the cockpit and sit in my old seat. But I'll tell you, it was a struggle getting in and out of there.
Not quite the same.
No, just to hop in and out like nothing,
The Wings of Freedom Tour is truly one of the most unique interactive displays of its kind, and guests are loving it. Reporting in Tampa for Bay Focus, I'm Brooke Rathmel.